going on? Welcome back to another episode of the Wonderful Arsenio's ESL Podcast, man. I'm your host, as always, and today is another wonderful TOEFL ITP reading course snippet, and today we're diving back into a vocabulary and context, the Concord Coach. Got some difficult questions here, some ways that you could overcome that, and again, an additional 4 questions will be available on my course, the TOEFL ITP reading course, if you are interested in that and interested in taking your TOEFL ITP score to the next level and seriously, you make sure you, I guess, just buy it, you know what I mean? Or follow me on the Arsenio's ESL podcast page and let me know what you think. And in saying that, people, again, a relatively short one. Stay tuned. There's a lot to be had and we'll go from there. Guys, so welcome back to another video of the wonderful TOEFL ITP course. So excited about this one. Again, another vocabulary and context, and here I am doing Concord Coach. Okay, so this one, oh man, with TOEFL ITP, I was just teaching, a coach and a student from the Middle East, and you know, one of the things with TOEFL ITP that really caught her off guard, although she ended up passing, big shout out to her, were the vocabulary and context questions. It's very difficult sometimes. They have very difficult, vocabulary terms. I remember I was doing one with her that is very similar to the TOEFL ITP test, and you know, I was looking and coming across some of these vocabulary and context questions, and they're so unbelievably difficult. So what you can do, again, to understand is by reading the sentence, obviously, that it's in, but also looking at the sentences before and after, because it will provide meaning to what is happening in the sentence. All right, 8 questions today, 4 for you, 4 for I. All right, we're going to be breaking this down. So let's do it. Number one, the word tranquil in line 1 is closest in meaning to peaceful, bustling, industrial, or tiny. So what we have to do is hurry up and obviously look for the word I just said the answer. God damn it. Because I'm like, oh yeah, tranquil. I know exactly what that is. But let's look at the context of it, all right? Manufactured in the tranquil New England town of Concord, New Hampshire, the famous Concord Coach came to symbolize the Wild West. That's all we have. Because then it goes into the body and the build of the Concord Coach, is such as it having a rugged body and a suspension system. So again, when we look at, okay, what does this word tranquil mean? New England town of Concord, New Hampshire. Well, I guess you're just going to have to, oh man, you're going to have to understand a little bit about, okay, a little bit about America. Okay, is New Hampshire. Okay, how many people live out there? I think less than 1 million. Okay, I could be wrong. And if I'm wrong, oops, sorry. Okay, shoot me. Anywho, there was a little video that had just popped up, but nonetheless, let's keep it going. So here we go. With that being said, okay, we're going to have to look at these vocabulary terms and just say, okay, well, New Hampshire, it's not like New York, so it can't be bustling. So we could hurry up and eliminate B. Okay, is New Hampshire, this town called Concord in New Hampshire, is it industrial? No. Now, could it be tiny or peaceful? Now, you heard me say peaceful, which is the answer, but why isn't it tiny? Well, the thing is, I mean, it is so hard to come across and see exactly what might be a very good indicator for it being, you know, for it being peaceful instead of tiny, right? And to be honest with you, there's just no real good indicator, you know? And I'm looking at the rest of it, okay, couldn't handle the hard jolts from the rough roads. A journalist, 1868, describing the road shipment as Wells Fargo Company, wrote that this splendidly, I see nothing. I see nothing that's, there's no reference to it being tiny. Okay, but if you, this is one of those sentences that if you do not know what the word tranquil is, which means peaceful, you more than likely will get it wrong. There's no indicator of it being busy, so we could take out B. Industrial, we could take that out. Although industrial, and if you're looking at some of these vocabulary terms, you know, referencing the Concord Coach, you may go with industrial. Tiny, there's no reference of that. You see what I mean? So if you don't know tranquil, you're gonna get it wrong. So that's one of those questions that are just going to suck a total amount of ass Do I believe that's going to be on the test? No, this is just a tiny bit obsolete. But nonetheless, I'm just preparing you for what you may end up seeing on the test, okay? Do not waste a lot of time. Make sure you do that one pass rule. Okay, look, I don't see bustling. I don't see industrial. Peaceful tiny, peaceful tiny, peaceful tiny, you know? And again, if you look at the term manufactured, you might think industrial. It's a hard one. It's a real hard one. But at the same time, tranquil is the vocabulary term that we're looking for. And that is peaceful. So in saying that, the word symbolize, okay? I love this term. You know I love this term. Let's hurry up and highlight it. The famous Concord coach came to symbolize the Wild West. What does it mean by that? Its rugged body and suspension system of leather straps could handle the hard jolts from rough roads. A journalist described the shipment of 30 coaches bound for Wales, and the company wrote that it was splendidly decorated. The bodies red and the running parts yellow. Each door has a handsome picture, mostly landscapes. And the interruption is here. People, thank you, thank you, thank you so much for tuning in to this wonderful TOEFL ITP episode. Again, if you want the full video and audio and the document and everything, it's available on my TOEFL reading course, all right? And in saying that, thank you so, so much for tuning in to another one. This was a phenomenal version of it. Hopefully, you understood a little bit. Again, if I just broke up in the middle of it, I do apologize, but man, there's so many more to come. So in saying that, thank you for tuning in to another episode. Follow me on my Arsenio ZSL, a podcast page on IG, on Facebook, and I'll be seeing you in the next episode.